So this is the second session on the oscillation, or you can say simple harmonic motion. Okay, so can anyone summarize what we had done the last class quickly? Like whatever you think of, whatever you remember, quickly type in, or you might have seen it before coming to the class. Quickly type in. Equations of SHM, okay, and causes of SHM. All right. So when we discuss the causes of SHM, what specific thing we had discussed last class? What are the things we have discussed? Specific things. Okay. What else? Steps of solving problem. Okay, what else? Anything else we discussed? So we had discussed a spring block system, right? We had seen in a spring block system how we can find out the time period of oscillation. All right. Yes, constant external force has no effect. You need a force which will try to push you towards where? You need a force which will try to push towards the mean position. Okay, what is a mean position? What it is? Mean position is what? Where, yeah, position of equilibrium. Position of equilibrium where net force is zero. Okay, that is the mean position. And when we write A is equal to omega square x, what is x? Acceleration when we write is equal to minus omega square x. This is the SHM, this thing equation. So what is x? X is the location with respect to the mean position. Okay, with respect to the mean position, it may not be extension in the spring. It may not be elongation in the spring. Okay, it can be elongation or extension also when spring is horizontal. Okay, otherwise spring will be already extended. When you put a spring vertically like that, there will be extension in the spring already. So at x equal to zero itself, a spring has extension. Okay, so keep these basic things in your mind and then only you should proceed. Okay, so I'm assuming like you guys have attempted the assignments also. And last statement what I said was, let me write it because it is important. What I said was, when you write A is equal to minus omega square x, and when you write V is equal to omega root over A square minus x square, the x is what? X is position with respect to the mean position. Okay, so your mean position is x equal to zero. All right, that is what I said. Okay, so now you know that just like any other mechanics chapter, this chapter is also full of numericals. Okay, so it's not that we'll just discuss a theory and just run through the chapter. Okay, so there are still many kinds of questions that we can solve. All right, of course I cannot take up all the questions, otherwise for entire year I'll be doing only one chapter. Okay, so let us start the session with couple of numericals based on whatever we had learned the last session itself, so that it get refreshed. Everyone, try doing this. Okay, Pranav got something. Others? What is the amplitude, everyone? Amplitude is how much? Amplitude is 5 meters. Okay. What is the time period formula? How you write time period? What is the formula for time period? Looking at this, can you tell anything? You can find out omega, right? 2 pi by omega is a time period. Omega is what? Omega is pi, right? A sine omega t plus phi. Omega is pi. So this will be equal to 2. 2 seconds. All right. And then we need to find maximum speed. The formula for the speed is written above. So using that formula, how you find the maximum speed? This one. What is the maximum speed in SHM? V max is omega into A, right? Omega is pi, A is 5. So 5 pi meter per second. All right. And also to find velocity at certain time. How you find out velocity as a function of time? X as a function of time is given. You can differentiate it to get V as a function of time. It will be 5 pi cos of pi t plus pi by 3. And you know, you could have differentiated this and then looked at that and find out when this velocity will be maximum to answer the V max. Like that also you can do it. Maximum value of cos function is 1. So V will be maximum, which will be equal to 5 pi. From here also you can get it. Now when you put t equal to 0 here, t equal to 1 here, it will be 5 pi cos of pi plus pi by 3. What is cos of pi plus theta? You know that? Minus of cos, right? So minus of 5 pi cos of pi by 3. All right. Now cos of pi by 3 is half. So the answer is minus of 5 pi by 2. Negative velocity means what? What does it mean, negative velocity? Which direction it is going? Left or right? It is going to the left hand side. Okay. And can you tell me the location where it is at t equal to 1 second? Can you find out the location where it is? How you find the location at t equal to 1 second, everyone? How you find it? Put t equal to 1 second here. Put t equal to 1 second there. That is a function of x with time, right? So when you put t equal to 1 second over there, you get x equal to 5 of sine pi plus pi by 3. What is sine of pi plus theta? You remember that? Sine of pi plus theta is what? Minus sine. You know that, all that, right? So minus of 5 root 3 by 2. So it will be here somewhere. It'll be here somewhere and going this way, negative side. Like that. Okay. So this is how you solve this question. Anyone has any doubt, you can type in. do this. Okay, Pranav got something. Okay. Do you remember for spring block system, what is the formula for time period? Do you remember that? Time period is 2 pi root of m by k. Okay, this is the time period. So from here, this is 3.14 is pi only. So pi is equal to 2 pi root over m by k. Why we are doing all this? Because I don't know what is k. I'm trying to find k. Why I'm trying to find k? Because the answer is k into maximum extension, which is amplitude. Okay, so that's why. So pi and pi got cancelled and 1 by 4 is equal to m by k. So k is equal to 4m. M is 5. So k is 20 newton per meter. So force is 20 into 0.1. That is 2 newton. Okay. So you don't need to again and again find out what be the time period as a function of m and k. I mean, just like you remember the time period of the pendulum formula, with practice, you will remember the time period of the spring block system as well. Okay, don't worry much about it. Do this. In terms of time period T, you have to find out how much time it will take. Okay, Aditya got it. Gayatri got something. Others? See, you can assume a simple form, simple harmonic motion equation, that is A sine omega t. Okay, omega is 2 pi by capital T, this into small t. Now I want to find out how much time it takes to go from 0 to A by 2 distance. So x equals to A by 2. Okay, so sine of 2 pi by t into small t is equal to half. So 2 pi by capital T into small t will be equal to pi by 6. Okay, because sine of pi by 6 becomes half first when it starts going like this. So t is equal to capital T by 12. Directly you can get it. Okay, and here you can get the multiple answers because it will not just go there once. It'll reach there, then come back to the same position, go there, again go back to the same position, and then again go there. So when you get the solution of this equation, you will get multiple answers. Okay, but I am interested in only the first answer of sine of what angle becomes half. Sine of pi by 6 is also half. Sine of 5 pi by 6 is also half. Sine of 2 pi plus pi by 6 is also half. Multiple angles for which it will be half. Do this. Can anyone tell me what is the amplitude of the oscillation for this one? In terms of K, M and all that, what is the amplitude? Correct. So see the mean position at the mean position spring is extended by mg by k amount, okay, and about this it oscillates, it goes up and down from this position. So when it goes down, it further stretches, but when it goes up, the stretching comes down, and if at the highest point it becomes unstretched, it means that amplitude of the oscillation is exactly equal to the initial extension, so that when it has highest point, spring becomes the unstretched position. All of you understand this, right? Everyone? Okay. Now, what is omega? Omega is root over k by m. Okay, and time period is given to us 10 times. What is this? 10 times per second is what? Time period or what? It is frequency. Time period is 1 by 10. 1 by 10 is 2 pi root over m by k. Okay, got it? So, this is time period, and we need to find what maximum speed of the block. Maximum speed is omega times A. Okay. Omega is root over K by M. Root over k by m, and a is m by k times g. So we are getting it as root over m by k times g. All right. So from this equation, root over m by k, root over m by k is 1 by 20 pi from this equation. Okay. So when you substitute it, you will get g, which is 10 into 1 by 20 pi. So 1 by 2 pi meter per second is the answer for the A part. All of you understand this? Type in. Everybody got this? Type in. Do the next part. Could you explain again? See, whatever is given to us, we are reusing it. That's all. Time period is given to us, 1 by 10, whose formula is 2 pi under root m by k. So from there, I'll get the value of root over m by k. Root over m by k is 1 by 20 pi from equation number 1, which we have. And maximum velocity is omega into a. A is mg by k, A, because it becomes unstretched at topmost position. So all that combined will yield this result. B part. Anyone got the B part? Different answer. Check for the silly error of yours and mine also. Do the B part, everyone. Yes, Pranav, that's fine. That's fine. Instead of writing 10, I could have written pi square over here. Answer is same. Don't worry. Pi square is roughly 10 only. How will you do the B part, everyone? Can you tell me what is the amplitude of the spring oscillation? How much is the amplitude? Anybody got the amplitude? See, from equation number one, again, you know, I'm doing the same thing. Root over m by k is equal to 1 by 20 pi. Okay. So if I square it, I'll get m by k is equal to 1 by 400 into pi square. And then mg by k, g is pi square, is 1 by 400 meters. So this is the amplitude. Okay. How much it is? How much it is? In centimeters. 1 by 4 centimeters. That is 0.25 centimeters is A. Okay. 0.25 centimeter is A. Now, you have to use V is equal to omega root over A square minus X square formula. Can anyone tell me what is the value of X for the B part if amplitude is this? What's the value of X? Will it be above the mean position or below the mean position? Everyone, will it be above the mean position or below the mean position? At mean position, spring is already extended by 0.25 centimeter, which is the amplitude also. Now, when spring is stretched by only 0.2, it is above the mean position because at mean position itself, it was extended by 0.25. So it is how much above from the mean position? 0.05 centimeter. Okay. Above the mean position. So you need to calculate X from the mean position. So X is 0.05. Don't ever put X blindly from here as 0.2. X is what? Distance from the mean position. It is initial stretch at mean position was 0.25, final stretch is 0.2 for the spring. So it is 0.05 distance away from the mean position. So now you can do it yourself, right? Omega we know, A we know, and X we know. Just take care of the meters and centimeter SI units. All of you understood this question? This was a good question. Everyone clear, right? Okay. I don't know you guys are ready for these or not. Let us see. Do this, all of you. What is the time period of oscillation, everyone? 2 pi under root. Small m by k. Others? Okay, Hariharan got something. Others? Okay, Pranav got something. You don't need to redo it. You already know for spring block system what is the time period. You need to fit in the formula for this situation. Okay, Shreyas also got it. So both the blocks are performing the SHM together. So 2 pi under root of m plus capital M by k. This is the time period, right? Now total mass of m plus m is performing SHM. There is no slipping, which we are assuming that there is no slipping. Both of them are doing the SHM together. Okay. Now, B part, this is A. Yeah, no slipping right now, no slipping. Sir, but isn't the friction force also changing? Yeah, let friction force change. It is an internal force. If I tell you a single block also, like this single block, then also I can say that the single block can be assumed to be made up of two parts, one above part, one below part. Okay, how do you know? Why do you care what is the force between above part of the mass and below part of the mass, as long as it is internal? So if they behave like a single mass, it is as good as this. Which block has only friction force in horizontal direction? Which block has only friction in the horizontal direction? Smaller one. So draw the free body diagram of the smaller one. Okay. Look at the forces on it and write down force is equal to mass m acceleration. You will get the answer. It is straightforward. Do it. Let me know once it's done. Okay, Hariharan got something. Let's say it is at the right hand side of the mean position. So what will be the acceleration of this block? How much will be the acceleration at a distance x away from the mean position? Everyone, acceleration will be omega square x, okay? And there is only one force that can provide that acceleration, and that is friction. Okay, rest all other forces are vertical in nature. vertically they are balanced, normal reaction in gravity. Okay, so the friction force should be equal to m omega square x. Omega is what? What is omega? Omega is root over k by m plus capital M. This is omega. So when you substitute it, you will get m divided by m plus capital M into k times x. This is the force of friction. Okay. Now do the C part. Throughout, we are assuming no slipping. Okay. Why do you think there is a maximum force of friction? Why? What is the reason? Why there is a limit? Because friction force has a limit. It cannot be beyond a certain value, right? How much maximum friction will be? Maximum value of friction is what? Mu time normal reaction is the maximum friction, right? Normal reaction is mg. So mu mg. Okay. This force should be greater than or equal to largest value of mass time acceleration, which is omega square into amplitude. All of you understand this? Whatever is the largest value that can happen, M into A, friction force should be sufficient to provide that acceleration. This is clear to everyone, right? So A and A gone. So amplitude should be less than or equal to mu g divided by omega square. Mu g by omega square is mu m plus m g by k. This is the maximum value of the amplitude. All of you clear, right? Any doubts, quickly type in. Okay. See, there are questions in which two masses together are doing simple harmonic motion. We have only catered till now situations in which only one mass is doing SHM. Okay. So I'm not sure whether you guys have done enough practice on the SHM or not. So probably next class, we can take up some questions in which two masses together are doing SHM. All right. Okay. So, maybe end of the today's class itself, if we get time, we can take such questions. How does that happen? A very simple example is, okay, I'll put the question here and we'll come back and solve it later on. This is the example. You can see both the masses are doing SHM together. Okay. this is doing SHM, this is also doing SHM. There is no fixed wall as such over here. Okay, so we will take this at the end. Right now, I'll leave the space to go to the next slide. Okay, write down the angular SHM. That question was in your assignment. That's good. So you guys have little bit struggled through. Now when I tell you, you will learn quickly. Okay, so angular SHM. Can anyone give me one example of angular SHM? Whatever comes in your mind. Pendulum. Pendulum. Okay. So, in case of angular SHM, what happens is that the oscillation with respect to angle happens. It means a very simple thing that in case of linear SHM, we track, what we track? The position with respect to mean point. Okay. In case of angular SHM, we track angle with respect to mean position. Okay. So, like you guys said, pendulum, okay, a straightforward example is a simple pendulum. Okay, so at mean position, it'll be here like this. Mass M, length L at mean position. When you displace it slightly, it goes this way and then it goes that way. Okay, so it swings with respect to its initial position and this angle changes, angle with respect to its mean position. All right, now can you tell me mean position with respect to the linear SHM is when net force is zero? Okay. So I'll write down mean position for linear SHM is when net force is zero. What is the mean position for angular SHM? What do you think? Everyone. Correct. Net torque is zero. Okay. Net torque should be zero. Fine. So from this position where the net torque is zero, you need to then find out how it is getting deviated. Now things are little bit similar. In fact, they are exactly the same compared to the linear SHM. Mathematically, they are exactly the same. What I'm trying to say is that if A is equal to minus omega square x is for the linear SHM, then alpha is equal to minus omega square theta is for the angular SHM. Mathematically, both are same because A is what? D square x by dt square double derivative of x. And alpha is double derivative of theta. Okay. Now, over here, I can say that what else? You have V is equal to omega under root A square minus X square. Okay. Here, what we can write? Everyone, what you can write here? If this is true for the linear SHM, V is equal to omega root over A square minus X square, what we can write here? Instead of V, what it will be over here? V is d theta by dt. Don't say V corresponds to omega because omega is angular frequency already taken up. Don't write omega here. D theta by dt is omega root over amplitude is maximum angle minus theta square. Okay. Yes, this is angular velocity. This is angular velocity. This is angular frequency. Omega is angular frequency. D theta by dt is angular velocity. Okay. Then you have x is equal to a sine of omega t plus phi. And over here, what should I write? Everyone, what should I write here? I'll write theta is equal to theta naught sine of omega t plus phi. Okay, rest all thing you can differentiate it and get it from here onwards. All of you are able to understand it, kindly type in quickly. There is this correlation between linear and angular SHM. How is d theta by dt different from omega? What is omega? Omega is constant of proportionality between a and x or alpha and theta. How is omega d theta by dt? Why do you think it is that? Just because we are used to seeing omega as angular velocity, we tend to think that omega should be equal to d theta by dt. Okay. What is the time period? Time period is same. In both the cases, time period is 2 pi by omega only. That doesn't change. Because do you think for mathematics, these two equations, they are different or same for mathematics? Mathematics will look at these two equations and will treat in exact same way or not? These two. Instead of A, I have written alpha. Instead of X, I have written theta. So mathematics doesn't care whether it is alpha or A or theta or X. Just like A is d square x by dt square, similar way alpha is d square theta by dt square. Okay. Previous slide, somebody has to see. That's all. I'll move forward. Okay. Fine. So now the question comes, how do you find out the time period of oscillation for the angular SHM? Okay. All the steps are exactly the same. Okay. All the steps are exactly the same. I'm not going to write down the same steps again. Just that instead of displacing by a small distance x from its mean position, what do you have to do? Can you tell me? Previously, when we wrote steps of solving problems, for linear SHM, we displaced it by a small and a small distance x. Now, in this case, what will happen? Displaced by small angle theta. Okay. Here, what you will do is that displace by small angle theta. Then what I have to see? In earlier case, I had seen that there is a force, a restoring force that get developed that again tries to bring the mass towards the mean position. Here, what will get developed? Correct. Here, a restoring torque. Restoring torque gets developed. So what you have to do is write down torque is equal to I alpha equation. All right. Then get the alpha is equal to some constant times theta. And alpha should be in opposite direction of theta. Okay. And then you can compare it with alpha is equal to minus omega square theta. You'll get omega. Straightforward thing. Okay. Now, if theta is very small, we are going to use this approximation again and again that sine theta is roughly equals to tan theta and is roughly equals to theta itself. Remember these approximation. Anyone has any doubts? Sine theta, if there is a right angle triangle, just taking an analogy here, is perpendicular upon hypotenuse. This is P by B. So when angle is very small, hypotenuse and the base becomes almost equal. If the angle is very small, this hypotenuse and this base becomes equal almost. So that is what it is. And moreover, it looks like an arc length, which is perpendicular divided by base. So that is the definition of theta itself. Okay, so that is why it's equal to theta also. Okay, so we are going to use this approximation multiple times. Okay, let's now again go back to the simple pendulum and see how to get the time period. Is this chapter done in your school by any chance? Not in DPS, not in YPR, no. Not in HSR also. Okay, so what I'm going to do is, I'm already displacing the mass M by a small angle theta. This is the length L. Okay, now I want you to get the answer yourself. Try doing it. Okay, Aditya got something. There'll be mg force acting on it, and there'll be tension force acting on this T. So how much is the torque about this point O? Everyone, what is the torque of mg? Torque due to mg is what? Mg into L sine theta, L sine theta, not cos theta. This is the perpendicular distance, right? This is the line of force, and you drop a perpendicular on it. Mg into L sine theta is the torque. Okay, this is the torque. Now torque is equal to I alpha. What is I, moment of inertia about this point? Everyone, how much it is for this mg? What is the moment of inertia for mass m? It's a point mass. ML square. So alpha is equal to mgl divided by ml square into sine theta. Okay, m is gone, one of this is gone. Now theta is very small, so sine theta is theta only. Now is theta and alpha, they are in opposite direction or in the same direction? Theta and alpha, theta goes this way, alpha tries to bring it back. Okay, alpha is in this direction, theta is in that direction, clockwise, anti-clockwise, so minus. So now when you compare it with alpha is equal to minus omega square theta, you will get omega is equal to root over g by l. So time period is 2 pi under root l by g. This is the time period. Okay. Now, why it is called simple pendulum? It is called simple pendulum because it is a simplest kind of pendulum. Can you think of any other kind of pendulum? Can you think of any other kind of pendulum? Correct. There can be a rigid body. Okay, like this pen itself, it can have an SHM. This bottle itself, if I displace a little bit, it can perform some oscillation like this. Okay, but then this is not a simple pendulum. This is a different kind of pendulum, and the name for this is physical pendulum. So write down physical pendulum. Can both angular and linear SHM? What do you mean? Didn't get. Okay, physical pendulum, let's say, we'll take an example to discuss that. Okay. Let's say you have a rod like this. Okay. This rod is hinged over here. total mass of the rod is m, length is l, this distance, the distance of the topmost part from the hinge is a. Okay, I want you to find out the time period of oscillation for this rod. At the mean position, it is vertically straight like this, isn't it? Net torque is zero right now. Then what you do? You displace it. Little bit angle. Both angular and linear SHM, yes, they can happen together. It can be like this, a rod, then there is a spring mass like this. So when rod is oscillating, this block also oscillates. But then you guys have to do a lot of problem practice your own, the basic level. Okay, so Pranav got something. Others, anybody else got anything? Nobody else? Okay. So at this position, gravity force will act from where? Gravity will act from center of mass. So this is mg. Can you tell me what is the torque due to mg about this position where it is hanged? What is this perpendicular distance? This perpendicular distance is how much? This is theta. this angle is theta. Okay. So this angle is also theta. This angle is theta. Okay. From here to there, what is the distance? This distance is what? L by 2 minus A. See, I intentionally made it little geometrically like this so that it should not be a straightforward thing, right? So this is L by 2 minus A. So the torque is mg L by 2 minus A times sine theta. All of you understand this? Type in. This is the torque. We are trying to use torque is equal to I alpha. Okay, now can you tell me what is moment of inertia, I, which I should be using there? No. If you use ICM, it is not ML square by 3 plus MA square. If you use ICM plus M into distance from center of mass square, ICM is what? ML square by 12 plus M into distance from center of mass square, that square. Okay. Now I think let's call this as this bracket, the white bracket, let's say C. So alpha is equal to minus C times theta is very small, this, okay? So omega is root over C, where C is this, okay? And time period is 2 pi root C. Is it clear to everyone, all of you? Anyone has any doubt, quickly type in. No one? Okay. Let's proceed. There, now you guys have learned almost everything about the problem solving. It's all about practice now, okay? So we'll do one more question, because you guys will see these kind of things quite often. So hence you should be. So I think the arrangement you can make of this is K1 spring, K2 spring constant, mass M, length L. This rod can freely rotate about one of its ends, which is topmost point. It can rotate. So you need to find out the time period of its oscillation. Find out. Yes, K2 is a midpoint, sorry. Anybody close to the answer? Should I wait or solve? Okay, 1 or 2 minutes take. All right, so nobody got it? So let us say the extension on the bottommost spring is x1. So it will be k1 x1 force. Over here, the compression on this is spring. This spring will be compressed. The bottom spring will be extended. But the good thing is that both will create the force in the same direction. This will be K2 X2. Okay. And that force is gravity MG. Okay. Now, the torque about point O is MG into L by 2. Sine theta plus K2 X2 into L by 2 plus K1 X1 into L. Do you all understand this torque? Type in quickly. Angle is very small. So the force into perpendicular distance remains that much only. Okay. All of you type in, everyone. Is it clear? Yeah. This is L. Okay. Now, how is x1 and x2 they are related? Is there a relation? Everyone type in. Is there relation between x1 and x2? Okay. Can I write x1 x2 in terms of theta? Can I write x1 and x2 in terms of theta? Right. Yes, direction of spring force will change and it will always try to bring the rod in its mean position. That's how the force should be, which is helping you to do the SHM. Okay. So x1, all of you agree, is L into theta, if theta is small, and x2 is equal to L by 2 into theta. And sine of theta is roughly equal to theta. Okay. So we can write down torque about O to be equal to mg into L by 2 theta plus k2 L square by 4 into theta plus k1 L square into theta. Okay, this is the torque. This is equal to I alpha, that is ml square by 3 into alpha. So alpha comes out to be mg L by 2. Okay, we can cancel out one of the L. One of the L is gone. How it is L square by 4? Abhe, X2 is L by 2 theta. Substitute here. So one of the L is gone. So alpha is mg by 2 plus k2 L by 4 plus k1 L. See, I just made up a question, so that's why the values are not looking so good. But there are many questions like this when you practice your own. That divided by ml by 3. This into theta. Now the problem is done. This bracket term, this term is your omega square. And time period is 2 pi by omega. Okay, so like this, you solve this particular question. Right. Okay, so let's move forward. There are many questions, you know. So let me just move forward and do a little bit of more theory. Then we'll again come back to the numericals. Okay. So write down the energy. Of simple harmonic motion. So basically, our main interest is spring block system. It's a relatively small topic because there is nothing new as such. Whatever you know about the springs energy and the blocks energy, same thing. It's a repetitive stuff, but slight bit of specific details are there. So if a block is doing SHM with a spring or spring constant K, okay, then the value of omega is root over K by M, okay. The amplitude is, let's say, amplitude is A. So can you tell me maximum potential energy, how much it will be, and maximum kinetic energy, how much it will be? Everyone. Maximum potential energy and maximum kinetic energy, how much it will be? Maximum kinetic energy, maximum, sorry, potential energy is half K into X square. What is the maximum amount of X? A only. So half K A square. Maximum kinetic energy is what? Half m into v max square. V max is what? Omega into a whole square. Omega is root over k by m. So you will get half k a square here also. Okay. Got it? Now in terms of x, at a particular moment, in terms of x, the potential energy is half k x square. And we know that in an SHM, V is equal to root over a square minus x square. So kinetic energy is half m into V square, that is omega square, a square minus x square. Now omega is root over k by m. So this can be written as half k times a square minus x square. So can you see that the sum of kinetic energy and potential energy is a constant? Can you see that? It doesn't depend on x. At whatever location you go to, when you add potential energy and kinetic energy, it is equal to half k a square only all the time. Okay. So why don't you do one thing? Draw a plot. Let's say this is the zero energy, and there's a maximum energy, which is half k a square. Okay. Can you plot the potential energy and kinetic energy on it? This center line is x equal to zero. This is x equal to zero. This is not zero. Left hand side is x equal to minus a. Right hand side is x equal to plus a. I want you to plot the potential energy on it. Everyone. It doesn't matter from where it starts. You have to plot this on the graph. Let me know once done. Okay, done. So potential energy will be maximum at x equal to minus a and x equal to plus a. And it is a parabola like this. So I hope all of you have got this. Okay, this is from your NCRT, whatever I'm discussing. Okay. Now I want you to plot the kinetic energy on the same graph, which a different color. Can you plot the kinetic energy? This is your potential energy. You plot the kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is this. Let me know once done. Look at the critical points. At x equal to 0, what will be the kinetic energy? At x equal to plus minus a, what it will be? And then join it with a curve. What will be the kinetic energy at x equal to minus a and x equal to plus a? Look at the formula. Zero. And at x equal to 0, it will be half ka square. It's a downward opening curve, right? Plot it. It will be like this. Okay. This is your kinetic energy. Fine. I hope it is clear to everyone. Nobody has any doubt. So, if the SHM is a system which is non-dissipative. Non-dissipative as in which friction is absent and there is no, let's say, drag force or anything like that. The mechanical energy will be constant. Okay. So there are ways to solve a problem by using the mechanical energy conservation. You can get the value of omega. Okay. So if you want, I can do one question where you can do the conservation of energy and get the answer of finding time period and things like that. I'll take a simple question only. Let's say you have a spring block system. Mass M, spring constant K. Okay. Then there is no friction anywhere whatsoever. So at any time, kinetic energy plus potential energy will be a constant, right? Kinetic energy is half mv square. Potential energy is half kx square. This is a constant. If it is a constant, what will be the derivative of this? If I differentiate it, if it is a constant, what should it become? Will become equal to zero. It's a constant. So when you differentiate it, you'll get mv dv by dt plus kx dx by dt is equal to zero. Now dx by dt is your velocity also, goes away. From here, you'll get dv by dt is equal to minus of k by m times x. Dv by dt is acceleration. So a is equal to minus k by m times x. So you got the SHM equation by using the conservation of energy also. Okay, this kind of method is very useful and easy, but it requires a lot of practice. Okay, so I'll send you a worksheet in which you can practice something like this, but right now you can focus on the force and the torque equation. And if you have time right now, after the class also only, then you can do the same question like this. All you have to do at any point in time, write down kinetic energy plus potential energy. It should be a constant and you will get the answer. Okay. In case of angular SHM also, you can write down the kinetic energy half I omega square plus mgh and differentiate it. Okay. When you differentiate mgh, you get velocity of center of mass, which is equal to omega into L by 2. So there are some certain things that you need to take care of, but then you'll get the answer. Okay. So yeah, so let's take a question. I have now, I think I'm more or less done with the basics of the SHM. I can take few questions, and then there is a third part of the chapter that I can discuss. Do this. Your concepts of rigid body motion will also be used in SHM. Okay, Pranav got something. Others? Okay, so moment of inertia is not coming in the equation. I is not coming. Are you sure? Two pi t I. What is that? Two pi r t I. Root I by k. Okay. Root I by k. Okay, so all of you tried, right? All right, so now let us move this down by a distance of x. Who is doing SHM? The pulley is doing SHM, okay? So you just look at the movement of the pulley. That's all. So movement of the pulley is such that it goes down by a distance of x from its mean position. Okay? It goes down by a distance of x from its mean position. How much spring will be extended? Extension the spring will be how much? Everyone, this length will be extended by x, even that will be extended by x, isn't it? If the pulley has to go down by x, it increases x length this side, x length that side. From where it comes? From the spring. A spring get extended by 2x. Are you getting it, everyone? Type in quickly. Is it clear to everyone? Why 2x? Because if cylinder has to go down by x, the length of this portion has to change by 2x. Okay. Yeah, let it rotate. Pulley is rotating. So what? But the length has to change, na? This length and this length, both are x. From where it will come from? From the spring only. 2x length will come, then only cylinder will go x down. Now, draw the free body diagram. This is 2kx. We don't know what is the tension over here. This is mg. Okay. Fine. So the there was an initial extension on the also on the spring. Let us do that as well so that you get a complete picture. When initially it was extended kx naught, this side is t. This is your mg. Everything was at rest, so pulley was not rotating. So this tension was also equal to kx naught only. So initially, kx naught plus kx naught is equal to mg. Now I've displaced it by a distance of x. So the spring force has become k times 2x plus x naught. Tension has changed from the earlier tension, which was kx naught plus, let's say, delta t. Okay. So the net torque about the center is what? K times 2x plus x naught times r minus k times x naught plus delta t times r. This is equal to I alpha. Do you understand this equation? All of you type in k x naught r minus delta t r is equal to zero. okay, minus, sorry, kx not r and kx not r will go away. So you will get k times 2x times r minus delta t times r is equal to I alpha. Okay. Now we also know that net force is equal to mass times acceleration. Okay. Earlier forces were all balanced, as in kx naught, kx naught, and mg, they were balanced. So if you write kx naught plus delta t plus k times 2x plus x naught, this is the upward force, minus mg is equal to m into acceleration of center of mass. So kx naught, kx naught, and mg, they get cancelled over because 2 kx naught is equal to mg. So we have delta t plus k times 2x is equal to m into a sin center of mass. Now what to do, everyone? These are the two equations. Now what to do? I have to write alpha. I have to write alpha in terms of acceleration of center of mass. So a center of mass divided by r. Okay, pure rolling condition. So substitute it over there. Using these two equations, remove delta t. Remove delta t using these two equations. Then write down acceleration of center of mass to be equal to something into x, and this something will be equal to omega square. So like this, you solve this particular question. All of you understand this? Just go through it once. There is no hurry. You can spend 1 minute. You don't need to hurry up. It can be in terms of r. See, r will be there. R is a constant. It should be in terms of x, so that you can compare a is equal to minus omega square x. This equation, when you compare, then only you'll get omega, right? Inside this bracket, there can be r, there can be m, there can be I. First equation again. See, first equation is torque about center of mass is equal to I alpha. Earlier, kx naught, and mg were acting. Okay, so 2 kx naught was equal to mg at the mean position. Everything was at rest. Then I have displaced the mass by distance of x. When I'm displacing by distance of x, the left hand side, the string length increases by x. The right hand side also, the length increases by x. So total increase in this overall length of the string is 2x. From where this 2x comes? From the spring only. So spring generates 2x into k force because the block gets pulled down by x. So k into 2x, the new extension plus the earlier extension. Here tension also changes when you leave it. Let's say tension, earlier it was kx naught, now it is kx naught plus extra tension. Then I'm writing torque equation. Torque due to this force is that force into the radius perpendicular distance. Torque due to this force is force into radius perpendicular distance. This is equal to I alpha. And this is what the equation is. Clear? Any other doubt? Normal reaction, where is a normal reaction? There is no normal reaction. From where you got it? Any other doubt, everyone? All right. Okay, so now we have seen many spring and block systems. Let's take a situation in which there is no spring block, but still it is an SHM only. Have you done this question in which there's a beaker and water? Have you done this? No, right? Okay, so let's do this. You have a beaker full of a liquid. This is from your NCERT textbook, the last question of your unsolved problem. Don't look at the final answer, do it yourself. This has density of rho. Okay, the beaker is full of a density of liquid rho. And there is a cube that is floating on it. Okay. There is this cube whose edge length is A and it is floating over it. It has a density of sigma. Sigma clearly is lesser than rho. That is why it is floating. Okay. You need to find out time period of oscillation. If what I do is that if I push it slightly down and release it, if I push it slightly and release it, then with what time period it will oscillate? All of you do this. What length is it submerged to start the oscillation? Doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. You can find out initial submerged length also if you want. but it doesn't matter. Okay, Pranav got something. Hariharan. Others. When you push it down further, what exactly happens? What are the changes that will happen? Everyone, when you push it down by a distance of x, what is the change that will happen? All of you type in, what do you think? Buoyant force increases. Very good. Buoyant force increases. So earlier the buoyant force balancing the gravity force. Earlier. Now, extra buoyant force is created. How much extra buoyant force is getting created, everyone? If I push it down by distance of x, what is the extra buoyant force that gets created? So the net force is the earlier buoyant force plus extra buoyant force minus mg. Okay. The earlier buoyant force was equal to mg. So the net force is the extra buoyant force only, which is rho dv. What is dv, Hariharan? What is that? Don't include another variable. Already we have so many variables. How much volume gets submerged further? A square into x. So extra displaced liquid weight is rho a square x, this is mass, into g. Okay, this is the net force. This is equal to mass m acceleration. Sigma a cube is the mass times acceleration. Let's say capital A is acceleration, small a we have already used actually. So capital A is rho g by sigma A times x. And clearly a and x are in opposite direction. So minus sign, this bracket term is your omega square. All of you got this? Everyone, any doubts? This is the time period of oscillation. Clear to everyone? Type in. Can you explain the last two steps? Last two steps, though, nothing. It is you want to see this one. This is the equation of SHM. A is equal to minus omega square x. If accretion is minus omega square x, then it is SHM. So I'm comparing whatever I have got with the standard SHM equation. And when I compare, I get omega as under root of this bracket term. And if you get omega, time period is 2 pi by omega. Okay. Any other doubt anyone has? Clear to everyone? So we'll meet after the break now. Okay. Fine. So let's take a break now. We will meet at 6:22 p.m.